Stepper motors are widely used in many electromechanical devices in our day-to-day life. For example, toys, robots, and open and closure of shutters in computers, video players, and windows, gates, many other places we use stepper motors for movements. 8051 microcontroller can be used to control rotations both clockwise or counterclockwise in small steps. Today, let us see a simple 8051 microcontroller based system for clockwise or counterclockwise rotation of a stepper motor. First, let us see what is a stepper motor. Stepper motor is actually a brushless DC electrical motor. Ordinary electric motor we see in fans, water pumps, where the motor rotates not into steps, with certain revolutions it works. But stepper motor is not like that. It's a brushless DC motor. It rotates in small steps. That means it divides a full rotation into a number of equal steps. For that, the stepper motor has several coils into it. The coils are energized in groups called phases. Here you see, this is the bipolar stepper motor. We have four phases in this motor. The phases are alternately or sequentially energized so that the stator coils are energized so that the stator poles attracts the rotor at the center so that it moves into small steps. So by energizing each phase in sequence, the motor will rotate one step at a time. This is the idea in a stepper motor. Now let us see how a stepper motor works. As I already mentioned, a stepper motor has certain number of field coils. We call it as phases, and a toothed rotor in the central portion. In this particular motor, you see four teeth and A, B, C, three pairs of field coils. If we have pairs of field coils, we say it is bipolar motors. In some motors, they use unipolars. Here, the pairs are together energized so that the torque of the motor will be a little larger. In the present system, we use a unipolar motor. Here you see the rotor has several teeth. In the field coils also, there are four teeth. So the step size is actually the angular displacement of a rotor in one step. The step size of the motor is actually determined by the number of phases and the number of teeth on the rotor. Here you see four phases and 50 teeth in the rotor. The total number of steps will be 50 into 4, that is equal to 200 steps. That means for a single step, the angle will be 360 degree divided by 200 steps. That means 1.8 degree. Let us start designing a system to control this stepper motor. We have the 8051 microcontroller where four ports are there. We use only two ports. The port 1 is used as input port and port 0 as output port. In the input port, we use only two pins, one for clockwise movement and another one for anti-clockwise movement. We have port 0 as output port where we use only four pins, P0.0, 1, 2, 3. These four pins are connected to the field coils or phases of the motor through an IC called ULN2003. This is an IC which is used to energize the field coils of the stepper motor. Normally, the current produced by the microcontroller is inadequate to energize the stepper motor. That's why to energize, we use this particular IC ULN2003. In this ULN2003, you see seven inputs and seven outputs. Actually, this is the low active IC. If you give low in the 1B as an input, the corresponding output is 1C. The output of this IC can be connected to the four phases or four field coils of the stepper motor. This is the idea. 8051 microcontroller and a driver IC and the stepper motor. How to do it? Suppose you want to move the stepper motor in the clockwise rotation. This is the sequence of energizing. First, we have to on the coil A. We have to give a low input to 1B that is connected to the port 0.0, low input. This particular IC generates the required current, 500 milliampere current, to energize the field coil. So the first coil energized. Now, after a small delay, the second coil, that is the B coil, has to be energized. So now, port 0.1 is made on by giving a low state. Then field coil C has to be on. For that, we have to give a low input in P0.2 and then P0.3. This is the sequence. 1, 2, 3 and 4. If we give in that way, the motor will rotate in the clockwise. Similarly, if you want a counterclockwise rotation, you have to move in the other side. First, you have to energize A, then D, the left side. This part has to be second. And thereafter, C and B. So, if you give like this, the stepper motor will rotate in the counterclockwise. So, this is the idea. Here, we use two switches, SA and SB. If you press SA, the motor has to rotate in the clockwise direction. If you press SB, the motor has to rotate in the counterclockwise rotation. Now, this switch has to be connected to the port 1, 1.0 and 1.1. SA is connected to 1.0, SB is connected to 1.1. Now, we have to generate suitable output to the ULN2003. The port 0.0 pin is connected to 1B. 1 is connected to 2B, 3B and 4B. So, we have to give a low input to these pins. Low input will generate a high output. This 1C, 2C, 3C, these pins are connected to A, B, C, D respectively. In order to activate a channel or a field coil, we have to give a low input to the ULN2003. The ULN2003 will generate a 500 milliampere current to energize the field coils. So this is the schematic of our system. Now we have to go to the programming side. Let us write a simple program to rotate the stepper motor in the clockwise four steps consecutively by pressing SA. Similarly, if you press SB, the motor has to rotate counterclockwise direction in four steps. This is the idea. Let us first initialize the port 1 as an input port and port 0 as an output port. We begin our program by setting the P0.0 as a high. At the initial stage, we have to stop all the field coils. So first A, B, C, D, all the four coils are now given a zero voltage so that all the coils are not working now. We ensure that the stepper motor is now off. Now, if we press SA, the SA voltage will appear at port 1.0. Automatically, the control goes to a location called clock. If we press SB, this instruction will check P1.1. If SB is pressed, the control will go to a location called C clock. There are two sub-programs. Clock is a sub-program which is used to rotate clockwise. C clock is a sub-program used for rotation the counterclockwise. Now again, the main program is repeated. Now let us see the sub-program for clockwise rotation. For a clockwise rotation, first thing is you have to give a zero in port 0.0. If you give zero to the ULN2003, that particular coil will be activated or on. The A is on now. A started moving. Now we have to give a small delay because there may be some time needed for a rotor to move. Till then we have to wait. For this, we have given a small delay for that. Then you switch off the phase A. Then we have to switch on the phase B, right? Now again you delay, then stop the phase B. Now we have to switch on the phase C. Switch on C, delay and switch off. Then the last one is switch on phase D, small delay and stop phase D. Now four steps A, B, C, D are sequentially energized so that four steps moved in the clockwise direction. Now return to the main program. Similarly, we have a subprogram for counterclockwise rotation. The same program has been modified such a way that the sequence is different. First A, second D, then C and B. The sequence is different. If we go in that way, the motor will move in the counterclockwise. So this subprogram is executed when we press SB switch. The previous subprogram will be executed when we press SA pin. Let us see a simple subprogram for time delays. It's a common program used for the timer counter function in the microcontroller. This register is loaded with the number 1D. This many numbers, it has to be repeated. We use the counter timer 0. Let us first load the count value for timer high and timer low. We have loaded the count value as 00. It is an up counter. That's why the counting value starts from 00. Now, first start the timer 0 by setting the TR0. Now, the timer starts. We have to pull or test the timer flag. Upon the terminal count, the timer flag will be set. This instruction will wait until the timer flag becomes high. This instruction will be repeated so many times till the TF0 is 1. Next, you stop the timer, reset the timer flag, decrement the register value. If it is not 0, again the control goes to the back position. So this is for time delay. This program gives ample time for the stepper motor to move one step. This simple program will move the stepper motor for counterclockwise and clockwise. Thank you for watching this video.